Of all the capacities releases that have come out in the time that I've been using it, queries are the one that I have been most excited for and most kind of impatient for, and they're finally out. I wanted to show you five ways that I'm using queries in my space in case it helps you get kind of inspired with what you can do with them. Now, on the Capacities channel, I did a bunch of videos about what they are, how to set them up, the different types, all of that. So we're going straight into the actual use case here. So I've got a list of five, and then obviously an extra one because I can never just choose five, of things I'm using right now. This will massively evolve over time, and there's probably a load more videos I can make about it, but this is where we're going to start. The first thing is with a random topic. So it's embedded in my daily note in Capacities, which means I get to see it every single day I come into Capacities to work on this stuff, and it is set up just to look in these object types and to show me one random result from it. And what this serves to do is make me excited about the things that I'm learning, the things that I have learned, the things that I want to sort of rediscover. Yes, I'm working mainly on the 12 centuries in 12 months project right now, which I've made some content on, but I still have other interests, and I really like just clicking the button and seeing, you know, all the stuff that I could get back into again. I take notes because of the joy of learning rather than productivity or anything like that. And this is just a super simple query that helps keep that at the forefront of what I'm doing. The random image one actually is in my home space, and here it is. I've done a video about how I use Capacities for home inspiration, which I know is incredibly niche, but it actually works very well. And essentially I have a very simple query set up here where it's looking for five random images. And the point of this, similar to the notes, is to show me things so I can say, okay, do I still like that? Would I still want that in my house in some way? Is it still inspiration? And frankly, sometimes it is very nice to look at, like, how beautiful is this? I will never in my life have a house that looks like that, but I love it regardless, and it's really nice to see in this space, and I just think it's quite fun. Then we have a query here called the work done so far about the 9th century. The 9th century is January's focus, so that's what I've been doing. And this query is looking in the object types that I know that I'm most likely to use. If I left the query just as this, it would show me everything, and that would be overwhelming. So what it's doing is it's restraining how many of the objects I can see by looking at the created at data, which is applied automatically to any object you create in Capacities, looking at stuff that I've created up until the 1st of February, when the focus switches to the 10th, and after the 5th of January when I started this project. And now initially it wasn't tied with 9th century either. What I did was I returned those results and I used the new bulk actions, which I'm loving, and added a tag of the 9th century, because obviously whilst this is my main focus, I have interests outside the 9th century too, and if something came up, I'm not taking notes just because I'm doing a project. However, the function of this query is to help me review everything that I've done so that I can build out the 9th century page, which I've just started doing. But you can see there that I was just starting to work it out. So this query tells me, okay, what objects should I be looking at? Which information from which objects should I be putting onto this page in some way? It's essentially just to help me scaffold that kind of synthesizing experience that is on my to-do list, because February starts this week. So once I'd added the 9th century tag, I then added that to the query to keep it more refined, and that's working very well. I will have one of these set up for each of the centuries, I'm sure, and obviously I'll probably be looking in the same places, but just updating the dates for when I was doing that century in this project. Again, related to the project I'm doing, I wanted a query where I could look at people that were alive in a certain century. And the way that I've done this is just by looking in the people object type and by looking for the years of birth and death. Essentially, I was just looking for people who were alive between these two dates, and then I put them in age order. It was worked out very nicely putting them in age order. It's really useful for reviewing, and it's almost like a timeline. I'm obsessed with timelines, so I really like that. And then I have a page called the processing page. Now, why have I got this? The reason that I use Capacities is properties. Properties are what I feel I personally need in order to help me harness the information and the knowledge that I want to collect, but with the understanding that my brain is just a little bit chaotic and doesn't remember to do things. If I have literally got in a given page, let's open this, for example, Charlemagne's page. If I have literal boxes to remind me to fill information in, then I will do it. If there is not, I will forget. As you just saw, I have just added the year of birth and the year of death of Charlemagne to his page. He did not show up in the people born in the 9th century page because I hadn't added those dates in. So the information that I've decided I want to see, which here is who was alive in the 9th century, is only possible if I filled in the properties. Now, instead of having to remember to go and check each property individually, you can just filter and sort your person object if you wanted to, but you'd have to start that again every single time. So I create something like this, which is a processing page where I can create a query that says, okay, you want to know that every person has a year of birth and a year of death. Show me those that don't have them. Now, obviously I've just given that example and I don't actually have that on here, but that's another point of this processing page. It emerges as the questions emerge. That very example, which wasn't planned, has just shown me that I need to add another query, and I will. Eventually there'll be loads in here, and it just allows me to have some either fun with queries or make sure the information that I want is in the properties I want it in order for my processes and the other queries to work successfully. And then the final thing is I wanted to touch on search queries being like unlinked references and talk about this. They're not officially unlinked references. If you've used other note-taking apps, so for me, Logseq and Obsidian, they automatically search for like any mention of a term in your graph essentially. And I used to love them because I thought that linking every single mention of an object here is the best way to take notes because you'd have more connections. Taking notes isn't necessarily about the number of connections, it's more about the, I guess, what you learn from it and all these other PKM things. So once I opened up Obsidian to my page about my former job, which was just called work, and I went to the link the unlinked reference button, and I linked every single instance of the word work, thinking I was referencing all the times I'd been to work. Now, I don't know why I even wanted to do that. Actually, I just linked every time someone mentioned that they were working on something or something had worked, and it was just crazy. And I did this, unfortunately, with a lot of pages because it was just so easy in Obsidian. That is not the only way that linked references work. I am sure that people use it in more sensible ways, but for me it was a distraction that just didn't serve the purpose that I was trying to deal with essentially. And I even tweeted about it because I liked it and I put it here, and this is proof that things change as you continue taking notes, because now I could never think of anything like it. So why am I talking about this now? I believe that the search query function in Capacities is like a better unlinked reference button because you have to be intentional about it. If you want to look for all of the mentions of a certain thing in your space, you have to craft that search query. And I believe that it's basically frictionless anyway, but it's still more friction than opening a tab in Obsidian and then clicking a button to link the unlinked references. And that just means that you think more carefully about what you're actually trying to do with it. At least that's how it works for me. So if I open up a search query and type in Charlemagne, and I want to look at everything to do with him, and I'll group it by type, the very first object that mentions Charlemagne is not even remotely linked to Charlemagne. It's linked to a source that talks about Charlemagne, but not directly. So where are we? We're here, and it's linked to the history of Charlemagne and not to Charlemagne. Now, to me, this tells me that this isn't doing its job properly. So here in the Charlemagne page, which is quite long because I've got a few properties, where I mentioned that he was crowned the Holy Roman Emperor, I need to add in this idea. I need to connect it to the person it's about. And instead of just blindly going through all these results and clicking link, 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 I'm thinking about what it needs to link to, which are the objects in my space, and then more precisely where it needs to link. It's a slower process, but it's a much more intentional process. And if that's one thing that I have learned about PKM, it's be intentional with it. That leads to clearer notes that feel less overwhelming. Capacities is my calm space where I come to be like the most curious version of myself. And as someone who has said 100 times that my brain is very chaotic, I don't want my note taking to become chaotic because then it won't make me happy. And that's exactly the point of me note taking, because it's my hobby. So I just wanted to add that in. Search queries are very easy to set up. And if you're someone that wishes that Capacities had unlinked references, this is essentially a way around it. But it, I think, accidentally forces you to be more intentional with how you use them rather than just blindly linking things, because unfortunately that probably isn't always what you actually need to do. So I'm very much enjoying search queries for that feature. I guess to sum up, most of the queries that I use now, and I presume I will continue using, are content type queries, because I store information in properties, and that is one of the key places content type queries are looking. By the way, I keep saying content type, it's the same as object type. I just get the two confused. They're the same thing. So I typically use those. But search queries are also great if you're someone that just wants to see where the object in question or the search term in question has been mentioned. But search queries are also helpful because they're a bit like unlinked references. In my opinion, they're better because I've learned from my mistakes. There is obviously the other type of query, which is the tag query. I haven't really been using them in this space because of how I kind of deal with notes, is, as I say, more to do properties and object types, but they're also very fun. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.